So hello everyone. So in this video we'll look at the HTML tutorials, which is a part of the web technology subject for UGC NET as well as the DSSB examination. So initially we'll start taking the subject as a theoretical subject, because we'll cover the basic theory in this first presentation, but my main focus was to show everything in a practical manner, because that way it will be much easier for you to understand how things are working. Now, one thing I want from your side, that try to make notes for HTML. What happened is, when I learned HTML for the first time, I was in, I guess, 8th or 9th class. So it took me hardly 3 hours to cover the entire HTML from very basics for a person who don't even know even a basic single thing about HTML. Okay, even I was not even knowing the full form of HTML. So HTML is a very, very easy language, or I can say it is a tagging script or scripting language or tagging language. Okay, it's very easy, and I hope after watching these video tutorials you'll not face any difficulty about HTML and all the questions in the examination, whether it is DSSB or it is UGC NET. You will be easily able to handle every question, you'll be easily able to solve all the questions one by one. Okay, so the first video, let us look at some theoretical part about HTML. So what is an HTML? Okay, so HTML is the standard markup language. So make sure that you understand these words, standard markup language for creating web pages. So generally when we create websites or web pages, we mostly use HTML. Nowadays we are using HTML5. That is the latest version of HTML. I'll show you what are the different versions of HTML. And HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. This is the full form of HTML, which is Hypertext Markup Language. And this HTML describes the structure of the web page using the markups. And what are these markups? Mostly we are going to use tags to build the structure of the web page. You will see what is that. Just follow the tutorials with me thoroughly. Okay. So even if you don't understand a word, don't worry. Now HTML elements are building blocks of HTML pages, and these HTML elements are represented by tags. So generally we have tags, like for example, if you want to write bold something, then you are going to write B like this, and hi, this is a text, this is a text, and then slash B. Now this tag is generally used to write something in bold. So whenever you are going to open this HTML web page in a web browser, it will show this text in a bold character that I will show in the later videos. Next is that HTML label pieces of content such as heading, paragraph, table, and so on, and the browser do not display the HTML tags but use them to render the content of the page. Okay, now let me show you. Now generally the HTML documents look something like this, as you can see in this part. So when you write an HTML file, that can be in a notepad, you can write different text editor, it can be a notepad, it can be notepad plus plus, and so on. There are so many different text editors which are available out there. These text editors can be different for Windows machine, they can be different for a Mac machine, they can be different for a Linux machine. That totally depends on your preference. So I'll show you how to write HTML tags or how to create HTML documents using a notepad or even with a special text editor like notepad plus plus. So generally we start the HTML document like this. That is doc type HTML, which says that it is a HTML5 version document that we will see. Then every HTML tag will be having its counterpart. That means if this is a starting point, then there will be an ending HTML tag also. Okay. Now everything which will be written in this document will be inside these brackets. Now the documents is generally divided into two parts. Number one, there will be a head section, and then there will be a body section. Okay, and before the head section there will be a tag which is saying that from this point the HTML is beginning and at this point the HTML is ending. So these two tags, this one and this one, which is saying whether the HTML codes are or tags are beginning at this point and ending at this point. And this is the head section. As you can see, this is the head section. In this section we'll display all the titles, all the headings of the web page, that you will see how these things are working. And then we have a body section. From here to here, as you can see, there's a body of the entire web page which is generally shown in your web browser. And here we can have different HTML elements, like this is a heading element, this is a paragraph elements, and so on. So we can have different kinds of element in an HTML document. Now the same points are written over here also. It says this doc type HTML declaration defines the document is a HTML5 document, and this HTML element is a root element of the HTML page, and this head element contains meta information about the document. Now we have the head element contains the meta information about the document. The title element specifies a title for the document. For example, here we have this title element. We specify the title for this document that we will see what is this title element. And the body element contains the visible page area, which is this part, or you can say this part. And these are the elements which are defined for this HTML page. Okay. Now this HTML tags are elements which names surrounded by angular brackets. Generally, if I write dash I and I write hi, this is a text, this is a text, and then slash I. I can use slash b, I can use different types of tags. So these are basically the tags which are surrounded by the angular brackets. And this tag name, let us say the tag name can be slash b, and the ending tag is always like this. B is starting tag and this is the ending tag, which is for the bold character, and in between these two tags the content goes. And the HTML tag normally comes in pairs, like this starting tag and this is the ending tag, which is used for paragraphs that we will see in practicals. And the first tag is a pair of the start tag and the second tag is a pair of end tag, and the end tag is generally ended by the forward slash, which says that yes, this is an ending tag. Okay. Now the purpose of the web browser is show the HTML document. If I show it like this, for example, this is an HTML document. Now in this document we have used the head, which is the page title. Now this page title, generally this area which is the head, this page title generally comes at this place, which is saying the page title. So when you see a web browser and you open an HTML web page, now this page title shows at this location. And now in the body we have different kinds of elements, like for example the first element is h1 heading. Now this h1 heading, when you open this web page or this HTML page in the web browser, then you will show that this is my first heading, which is generally in written in h1 tag, because h1 is the biggest heading. We have different kinds of heading, h1, h2, h3, that we will see. We have h1, we have h2, we have h3, and so on, different kinds of heading tags that we will see what is the purpose of all of them and how we use, because the size also matters and size also differs. And then we have written slash p or p that shows a paragraph. So this is the content of a paragraph. So we could have one more paragraph here which also start with p and ending with slash p. We can have multiple paragraphs, so it will show those text written between these two containers, or these two tags will be in the form of a paragraph. Now you see, generally the HTML document is something like this. We'll be having starting HTML tag and ending HTML tag. And then we'll be having a head section like this, which contains all the head or metadata information about the HTML page document. And we have a body section which will be surrounded like this. And here we have all the text which we want to show inside this HTML document. Okay. And here we use this declaration which represents the document type, which helps the web browser to display the web page correctly. It can be a HTML document, it can be HTML5 document, what kind of document it is, that is denoted by this tag. It must only appear once at the top of the page before any HTML tag, and it is not a case sensitive. You can write this in a small also, like you can write like this DOCTYPE doc type. So that is also correct, because HTML tags are not case sensitive. You can say HTML tags are not case sensitive. Okay. And this is a declaration of HTML5 document. You generally declare the HTML5 documents like this. Now there are different versions of HTML. Initially the HTML was introduced in 1991. That version was called as HTML. Then in 1995 HTML 2.0 version was introduced. Then in 1997 HTML 3.2 version was introduced. 1999 HTML 4.01 version was introduced, and in 2000 XHTML was introduced. Now this version was there for a very long time. As you can see, in the initial years, every 2 or 3 years they represented, they introduced one latest version of HTML. So you can see the HTML was frequently being developed between the time period of 1991 to 2000. They have introduced 4 different versions of HTML, but after the year 2000, the invention, or you can say the progress, stopped because this was a very successful version. But in 2014, because we also felt that we need IPv6, and the internet also broke, the internet becomes so much popular with everyone, there's new kind of elements, the kind of content that people was who are browsing over the internet is of mediocre type of content, or the different kind of content that people are browsing. So there was a need to reinvent HTML. So they have invented as HTML5. So whatever we are going to study in this course will be in the HTML5 version. And this HTML, in this HTML5 version, we'll see all the elements. Obviously, there's not a huge changes. There's just some new text that are introduced between these versions, and there are some tags which they made obsolete. But still, we'll be studying HTML5 version for our examination, and we'll try to cover all the previous year questions also. But the main focus will be on practical side, that we'll try and show how these tags are working in a practical fashion, okay, or practical scenario. So this is the first video was very theoretical that I wanted to show. But in the next video, let us start with the basic HTML tags and how to use those tags. Okay, thank you for watching.